Assalamu alaikum everyone and welcome back to Al Hijabista. I hope you all are doing really well. Today I bring to you guys a really beautiful and exciting video. So I was sent the new Ramadan Planner 2021 by Afia from beyondbooks.goa. This book is an all-in-one planner which will help you track everything that you need in Ramadan, from your ibadah to the meal plans, grocery shopping, Eid shopping, everything and anything. Using this planner will help your Ramadan be so much more systematic, and you know, this is the best for your time management as well. So for the ease of making this video, I have divided this planner into 5 parts and I will be showing you each of it in detail so that you can understand how to use this book effectively to plan your Ramadan. So at the start of the planner, we have a dua for Ramadan, and then the first part of the planner is the pre-Ramadan preparations. So it includes everything like planning our meals, grocery, iftar gathering, everything before Ramadan, so that everything is organized and good to go. So first we have a to-do list before Ramadan, which is divided into 3 categories: the must do, the should do, and do if we have time. So you can categorize your tasks in order of their priorities, what needs top priority and what can be done if you have free time. So I like how you can, you know, add all of your tasks in this, something like cleaning up the house, which could be the top priority, and something like Ramadan decor, if I have time, I would like to do. Then on the next page, we have the most important page for us ladies, which is the meal planner. So I think most of our Ramadan goes in deciding what to prepare for iftar, what to prepare for sahur, and what to prepare for dinner, and the grocery list as well. So this page is something I'm so excited to use. So we can just put in the Ramadan date and just write down all of our meal ideas at one page and just look and cook. That's it. We don't need to think, don't need to waste time thinking what to cook and how to cook. And here we also have a grocery list, which I'm excited to use because we need to purchase a lot of stuff before Ramadan so that we don't waste time shopping during Ramadan. So again, I'm deciding, you know, to use this grocery list and take it when I go out so that I can, you know, shop everything, make sure I don't forget anything, don't miss out anything. So this meal planner and grocery list is very, very helpful, obviously. And along with that, we also have a shopping list as well, and we have an iftar gathering planner as well. So you can just write down the number of people you're inviting, say 5, and you can plan out your appetizers, dinner, desserts, and grocery list as well. How beneficial is this? Like, seriously, I love it. And then we have the eat planner again. So we have the food to make, which is obvious, I think, in everyone's house, it's biryani. And we have an eat outfit and eat gifts. Next up, moving to my favorite part of the book, which is the dua checklist. So we have a section in this book for all small little duas, like the forgiveness prayers. We have some duas from Quran and Sunnah, which includes small little duas, which you can read all, you know, around the day, and you can teach your small children as well, because some of these are really nice for zikr o azkar as well as, you know, tasbih. And then we have a very detailed English dua which I would love to recite at the time of breaking our fast. So I'm really looking forward to reading this dua at the time of breaking the fast. And in this dua section, we also have a dua corner. So here we have a little ahadith and information regarding how powerful your dua is. And then we have a dua list. So we can list down what all we need for dunya, akhirah, family and ummah. I really love this dua list. We often tend to forget, a lot of people who, you know, tell us to make dua for them, but we tend to forget them during Ramadan. So you can write down the names or things specifically that you might tend to forget, and that way we can open this dua list, see what's in here, and you know, make dua for each and everything and not forget about it in Ramadan. We also have the suhoor and iftar dua in Arabic with its transliteration and in English meaning. So this is something really nice to teach your children if they are small. We have the Asmaul Husna. Again, if you want to learn by yourself or with your children, we have the Ayatul Kursi. We have the Sayyid al-Istighfar or the Master Supplication for forgiveness. We have a lot of more great duas, big and small, that you can learn, you can read, you can recite all over Ramadan. So this is my favorite part of the book. I love the duas. Coming to the next part of the book, which is the Ibadah tracker. So we have a welcome Ramadan page here, and we have some lovely duas here that we hope that our Ramadan is blessed and prosperous and is very beneficial, and we gain maximum advantage from the Ramadan. And then coming to the Ibadah tracker pages. So the first page is My Ramadan Goals. So we have like a holistic personality development page. You can write down everything from your Quran, Sunnah, Zikr, charity, personality development. And then we have the Salah tracker. So we can highlight each of our prayers for the 31 days of Ramadan or 30 days. And this way we can, you know, track all of the Salah. I really like this page. It's going to be really nice and colorful at the end of Ramadan, inshallah. Then we have the Quran tracker, which is also very similar. We have 30 juz sections, and you can highlight whenever you finish one juz, or if you're someone who reads more than one Quran, you could just like put a tick on top of juz one tick for one Quran, two ticks for two Qurans, and three for, you know, three or more. Next up, we have the page for Quranic reflection. So we oftentimes tend to read some really, you know, beautiful ayats in the Quran, which we want to remember, but we often tend to forget when we want to recall them. So we can specify the ayat, you know, number and surah number, and write down something that personally touches us a lot in the Quran. And then we have the habit tracker and the good deed tracker. So these are similar. A habit tracker, again, you can add there's a 31 day checklist here, so you can add something like maybe tahajjud, waking up for tahajjud, or maybe taking a 15 minute walk, or you know, having 8 glasses of water, something like that, and mark out all of the days. Then we have the good deed tracker, where you can write a small little good deed that you do every day, maybe like solving someone's problem or giving a little sadaqah, anything like that. Then we have the 30 days of gratitude challenge. So you can question yourself each day in Ramadan about what you're thankful for. Like here, some of the examples are like, what about your body are you thankful for? What in your life are you thankful for? So there's so much to be thankful for, and we often tend to not realize. So I really like the concept of the gratitude challenge. Then we have a little information on taqwa, and then we have a list for sisters who cannot pray in Ramadan in some days. So we have a small little beautiful section here for what can you do if you cannot pray. There's so much you can do, and we often tend to miss out on these really great practices that we can do and be spiritually active even when we are not praying. Then we have 6 steps to get closer to Allah. We have a little Quran memorization information. We have 4 poisons of the heart. Some really nice beneficial information here. Then we have the zakat planner. So we can write out the person's name and amount and track out all of the zakat that they are giving in detail. We also have a sadaqa checklist, which is very similar, again with the name and the amount. Then we have a general notes page here, which you can use to calculate your zakat. Maybe, you know, write down your property and cash and gold and calculate your zakat, so that it's easier to keep everything in one place. Everything is in one place. It's not haphazard. It's not all over the place. So now coming to the fourth part of the planner, which is the 3 Ashuras planning. So the planner is divided into 3 ashras. So we have the first 10 days of Ramadan, and we have this page for all of the 10 days. So we just have to write the Ramadan day on top. It's 1, 2, 3, and we have small little sections like goals for today, good deeds of the day, task for today. Then we have a Salah tracker where you can tick if you have finished all the Salah. And then we have a Taraweeh and Tahajjud checkbox as well. We have a Quran recitation from where did we start, which surah number, which verse number, and where did we finish. We have a meal plan, sahur, iftar, dinner. So you can see how detailed this planner page is. Then we also have today I'm grateful for, dua of the day, today's priorities. So this page is so detailed and it capsules everything that you need to do in your day. So everything is in one place. So you can just look at this one page and go about your day. No confusion, no time wasting. Everything is sorted completely thanks to this planner. And then we have the second Ashra. So again, we have a divider here, and then we have again the same 10 pages. And right before the third Ashra, we have a little Laylatul Qadr information. So first we have what is Laylatul Qadr, and then we have a Laylatul Qadr tips and to-do list, checklist as well. So we have some tips on how to not waste time and not do anything other than pure ibadah during Laylatul Qadr. We have some goals, to-do list, duas to make, surahs to recite. So again, see how well this planner lays out everything that needs to be done even in the special nights. So then we have the third Ashra, and again the planner pages. So all of your 30 days of Ramadan are sorted to the dot in absolute detail. And last we have the Eid and Shawwal essentials. So we have a Eid al-Fitr Mubarak page, and we have a detailed sunnahs of Eid al-Fitr, so you can see all of this. And then we have a Zakat al-Fitr page with the significance, and you can write down the person's name and the fitr that you've given. You can also add in lines if you have more family members. So yeah, that's sorted as well. And lastly, we have the Shawwal fasting tracker as well. So after Eid, all of you who also keep the 6 fasts of Shawwal, as said in the Ahadith, which is written here, so we can again have a Shawwal fasting tracker as well. So this does not stop till Ramadan. It even goes till the Shawwal. So it's that all inclusive. This planner is so all inclusive. And at the end of the planner, we have the post-Ramadan reflections. So you can just ask yourselves, how was this Ramadan different? What did you achieve this Ramadan? And what are you looking forward to after Ramadan? So this was the entire planner, so detailed. It encapsulates everything from the first Ramadan to even Shawwal. So that's how all inclusive this planner is. And there's also so much that you can even learn stuff that we didn't do last Ramadan. With the help of this planner, we can also apply those, use those things, and make this Ramadan so much more easier to go about. No more confusion, no more cross-checking, consulting. Everything is sorted before actual Ramadan starts. So just imagine the amount of time we can spend solely in ibadah, in Quran, in Salah, all the good deeds. So now let's talk about the page that sells this. So if you want to get your hands on this beautiful Ramadan planner, where do you go? You go to the Instagram page beyondbooks.goa. I'm going to be linking their WhatsApp, their Instagram page in the description down below. They are also available on Amazon, so you can check out beyondbooks.goa Ramadan Planner 2021 on Amazon as well, and you can get your hands on this planner, because believe me, your Ramadan is going to be so much more easier to handle, because everything, it's like a mini assistant. You have a Ramadan assistant now because of this planner. So I really want to thank Afia for sending me this beautiful planner. I cannot imagine how I survived all these Ramadans without this planner. This is my Siri. I think this is going to be my virtual assistant, my Ramadan assistant. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I hope you have a very blessed and prosperous Ramadan, which is beneficial for you in all ways, emotionally, physically, socially, spiritually. I hope this Ramadan you get to develop your personality. It helps you on your journey of spiritual healing and all beautiful things. So a very, very happy and prosperous, blessed Ramadan Mubarak to you all in advance. And make sure you check out this planner, because you need this, girls. Be a boss woman, be a superwoman, and use this planner. You'll have everything sorted. I hope you enjoyed today's video. I will see you next time. Till then, Assalamu Alaikum, and do remember me in your duas this Ramadan.